Yeah, I think you're in a wrong relationship when you're not comfortable with that relationship. What I mean is that, for example, probably you used to be on a 3.5 in your academic or whatever. Then all of a sudden you're in the relationship and your GPA starts dropping. And your so-called partner calls you and is like, okay,
and they want to compromise.
But you keep saying, like, if you want me to still be in this relationship,
I think that's why most important thing is that it's actually good for the person, like, you to know yourself, like, how you're supposed. Because I can't imagine myself, that's me, though. I can't imagine myself being in a relationship with somebody, and then the person is more like, because of my downfall, are you okay? Are you what are we doing?
It's not about academics or age, it's not about maturity. If you are matured enough, you can go into
relationship and still be in school.
So people also get married soon.
You can go into a relationship when you can see the end. Not like a relationship that you're asking him, when are we getting married? He's telling me when I go to Nigeria, do you start
this? That's one reason why I think, to an extent, before you go into a relationship, have an idea of what you want already. And be sure that, okay, in the next 2 or 3 years,
I am married.
Ring. I don't know why you'd be in a relationship.
You want to get married, but the guys think it's not.
That is the reason why I'm saying, personally, if I call a guy and tell you, wait, brother, wait, even if you're asking me out, after three months, bros, when do you want to get married? I'm not desperate.
You don't expect
3 months. No, like 3 months of your conversation. Communication matters a lot.
You know some guys know that some ladies are into relationship because they know that that lady is desperate. They'll tell you in the next.
But you know some guys used to be that pressure. Like
you used to be I don't know, but I think when it comes to the issue of marrying or getting married, this kind of thing, it will take a while because that's what I mean. Even before I would want to go into a relationship, let me say that person is financially stable. Let me say that that person is someone that is financially stable. There's no amount as financially stable, but like the person has something to take, the person can take care of himself. So that I know that okay, within the next 1 year, within the next 2 years, although we know that anything can happen, but like we just have like okay, within the next 1 year, 2 years, that person can still.
It doesn't mean you shouldn't be able to talk, or you don't need to make decisions yourself. It doesn't make sense because my mommy said that she
Jesus, when this guy is dreaming, he's dreaming about me. when you have 50,000 and when you take me of something, it's me you give the money to first. I thought that you have signed. Mommy, I tell my mommy I want your daughter. They say, okay, carry you go. Nobody talk to your mommy, no problem, it's okay.
That's the
person that I because I'll definitely talk to my own mom. Yeah, so I don't have a problem with you doing all that. My problem will come when you can't take major decisions without consulting your mom. Okay, and maybe what color should the house be? And then become my mom. I mean, I'm going to be a mother someday, and I know that the bond between mothers and their son is usually very strong. So as he grows up, you just begin to let him to go.
Absolutely.
You just begin to let him to go. You don't wait until there's a lady in his life.
It's not just that easy though. It's not really that.
But do you know?
Some of the things that I've heard, it's love that will make a woman want to go the extra mile. There is you too. We are not saying you should be perfect, but if this guy loves you, he will appreciate your efforts. Yeah. I've met men that I remember when I was in Nigeria, like this man, even if he travels, he cannot eat even fast food because he wants to go home and eat his wife's food.
Wait, it's not I like you for you after before marriage.
Okay.
Why? No, don't worry. When we get inside you,
it's not. I don't think it's bad.
It's not really, really, really bad. You know, like the reason
is to buy necessities.
Like in my house, I think the reason why that is, if I feel like cooking, when we are still dating, like we are still dating, if I feel like cooking for you that time, that time we are around, and I feel like okay, I want to cook for you. We are dating now. Eh? Then I go is if I feel like I'll go. But if I don't feel like cooking it, I am single. I am still single.
Who maybe you have the mentality that when you get married, you are suddenly under this person, so you have to do everything.
No, you don't have to do everything.
You're saying I'm single, so I'm not cooking for you. When I'm married,
no, it's not like it's not like I'm not like cooking for you. Probably because I'm joking.
Like
when it comes to my house, probably when we're still dating. If I'm in the mood to cook.
That's what I'm saying. When you're dating, you feel like it's a mood. That means to you, dating is a period where you can't do anything you feel like.
Not really.
No, that's how, excuse me if I'm not getting your point, but that is how it's being portrayed. Dating is not.
So are you trying to say so just because is around now and while we're still dating, I just have to cook?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying there is a way you are painting dating and you are painting a marriage. It's like one does not lead to the other. It's like you have to do things differently in a marriage.
Kind of. You have to do things differently
so
in a marriage.
So why do you date?
It's something that leads to. It doesn't lead to marriage.
It leads to it. So it should be a continuous process.
For me, dating, it's not 100% guarantee to marriage.
Yeah.
So that's why some people could. For me, dating is not marriage.
Mm-hmm.
And there are certain things that should only be done in the comfort of marriage. One of those things, of course, we know is sex. It's like it's your obligation. It's what you have to do. There are other things that I feel like we are not married. There are things that when you get married, by default, you just know that this is what you have to do. Some ladies have made guys too comfortable that they don't see any reason to even commit. You dress up, you go to their house in the morning, you do everything, you even sleep over 1 week. Why should he do anything extra to get you when he's already having everything?
Of course, like that's a matter of maturity.
Well, of course, maturity comes to play. You have to balance it.
I feel like because of the way we treat relationships and marriages, that's why shit goes wrong in marriages. Because guys can feel, okay, have your fun, but dating, you don't want to do this, you don't want to do that, you choose, feel, do. When you are married, I've not paid your bride, but that's why they feel, oh, okay, now I have a money, I can now do what I want. Because in the relationship, you have given up this vibe that, why not?
I think we are seeing it differently. I'm seriously not going to do everything my mom does for my dad for whoever I'm dating. Until you're my husband, there are certain rights you don't have yet.
Basically, for me, I don't think anybody that is having that mentality of wana man, you are now my
exactly.
It is mindset, it's so wrong. It's so not mature. Because when we are in a relationship where we are also looking at it, okay, we are going to marry. For me, I feel that process.
That's not what you're saying, but you are suddenly removing your own
part of the whole this thing and then making it all about
of course thing. I'm not so into what she said before about the cooking issue of violence because
we're not talking about cooking.
No, because that's the thing that was led to that.
Something. I think there are things that of course I believe that, I also don't believe that dating is exactly the same thing with marriage. But even if we refuse to, you know, I'm not talking about maybe things like there are things that is not even I cannot let me say when she talked about sex, it should not be. But there are things that we just know that this one there is no talking about it. If the person thinks it's okay, then he's also definitely not the one. But there are things that are not about our value system. There are things that we can compromise. Even if we can't do it, let's not be defiant about it. Like yeah, what you said about cooking. I have a friend, she doesn't like cooking. Like, naturally, should the guy now come and maybe there, if she has other things to offer, she has her brain, she's supportive, she's committed. It's no more that she must be turned into a cook. This one, they can walk their way through it.
Exactly.
I've met people that will say that their wives can't cook. That they cook for their wife. My other person used to say that he will cook for his wife. He likes cooking and he doesn't have a problem with wife.
So, I was asking a question now. You are still in a relationship with somebody and the person always calls you my wife. What are you supposed to tell the person?
I'm not cheating my wife.
Or you do like this. Where is it?
So from before, now we have this thing.
No, you come back. I'm my wife. So I'm learning now. I want to learn. Somebody calls you that, hello, my wife. And you have not taken me to water.
No, you still. No, I'm not saying you should not seriously say what you want to say. Our wife, I'm not your wife. I'm not married. You should, while you are standing your ground, you should also consider the other person as a human being, as somebody that has feelings that might get hurt if you say to. There was a time you said something about being blunt. You want to be told the truth, but you don't want it thrown at you.
That's where maturity. That's where I think the maturity comes in. You
have. Listen, you're saying that's what. I'm so sorry. That's why communication is one of the key. You know, but do you know some of us? Somebody like me now. You know me. I don't know when I'm telling. When I'm talking to somebody, let me put it that way now. You know this one that will now say, it is. Let's call it grey. It's not really black. Me, it's not like when it comes to
the part that talked about the container principle.
I love that.
Me too. I had to write that.
Can somebody read the principle?
The container. I read the book. I tried to relate it to real life experiences. Sorry, I mean the people. I feel like that is what happens to human beings, speaking in fuck boys. They come. If you look at human beings like that, you understand that in as much as human beings make choices and everything they do is a product of their decisions, some of these things they don't have exact hold on them. They can't do anything about it because they don't know generally. They will not
container. The first thing is that no container is immune from puncture. As beautiful as a container could be, something could happen and it gets punctured. That's, I think the book likened us to containers. We are not immune, but when those things happen to us, we should refuse to stay there and then just think that, we cannot be fixed. Our generation, what most of us do is we use one relationship to heal another one. We are coming from this relationship that messed us up. And instead of trying to fix it, trying to see how we can bring out that good version of us again. We just believe that entering another relationship will make us happy. And you know that a good, even though this guy, the new guy, is a good guy, just because we are not in our best state, our attitude will make that person to look bad. Why in the recess? That's not who the person is. So until the container has been fixed, the container loses its rights to ask for more content. Once you have been fixed, we shouldn't just like use relationship to heal relationship, use people to heal our emptiness and all of that.
As much as it is very, very nice to be you, and you know, there's a place of concentrating more on yourself and be sincere with yourself. I need for you to be patient, just take your time. When you take your time and me personally, I believe so much in the word of God. I believe so much in, now I'm diverting a little bit now. I believe, because when it comes to wound and hurt, as much as it is nice for you to take your time and, you know, there's a place of God in it. When you, if you do not allow that place of God to, if you do not allow God to heal you, it's going to be a serious struggle for your own part.
How can you draw the line between like personal intimacy and showing concern? Like any person, is a girl or a guy?
Okay, I'll speak for girls. So generally, pain makes girls vulnerable. Whether it's pain, loss, exam, whatever it is. So there are some things that you shouldn't necessarily allow a guy to be the one to comfort you. Find healthy females that will be there for you, because pain makes a girl vulnerable. If the guy doesn't like you, there are chances you end up liking him. And at the end of the day, someone will get hurt. And most times it's a girl that it will affect me. So pain makes a girl, pain can even make girls do something that they even want to do. Because the guy will get you to trust him. He probably had good intentions at first, then he opened up, then one thing leads to other. Maybe everybody didn't understand it, but he understood it. But I feel like pain makes girls vulnerable. So
I think it's in this same author, another of his book I read, Essential Purity. He answered that question. He said that by default, ladies will migrate to whoever give them care, attention, and respect. I don't forget that. Care, attention, and respect. Whoever it is, a hand rubber give them that, they would. You see a lady will start saying, it's not that bad.
It's just me somehow.
Whoever gives them
care, attention, and respect. So when she becomes vulnerable due to pain, and then this is the person who is giving her. So I think that we should just be careful who we allow to give us all of this, because by default we would just start seeing something nice or something.
I'm coming and I hope you enjoyed yourself and you learned one or two things from everybody, because you know, understanding that wisdom is not just one person. You have to get from one place, get from game. So thank you, and I hope that when I call you next time, you will come.
No.